Psychology and finance. Those two things we deal with every day. And sometimes I wonder, what comes first? Psychology that deals with people's brain and feelings and heart, or money that deals with taxes, interest rates, present values? Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, owner guests, let me share two stories about the convergence of the two major elements of our life. The story number one, psychotherapist calls me up and says, Tatiana, I have a referral for you. I have a couple that was in family therapy quite for a while. I meet the couple, husband and wife, and my first question, I go through my routine, like a nurse would go through the vital check at the hospital, and I'm asking the gentleman, how much are you making? He says, I'm making $500,000. Wow. But how much is your disposable income? What is that? I don't know. Well, this $500,000 you're making, how much of that you have in cash to spend on bills and put away and on vacation and your wife? And both, honestly, didn't know. So we had to go through rigorous checking to exclude his unvested stock options, to discount his available income by tax, exclude his Harry Rosen trips, his new BMW every other year, his luxury lunches, because you have to hang out with the top performers in order to make top money, so that is an expense. And we came to a mere number of maybe $6,000 or $7,000 a month that they have available for monthly spending. And that taught both of them a lesson that what was in their mind as a $50,000 a month income was not even close. They barely had $6,000 in cash to spend on the family. And that led the two to reconnect. And the wife realized that she can't go on the shopping sprees to Italy anymore because her husband is not making as much as she thought he did. And he also had to put his vanity and put his kind of self-importance down because it wasn't 50,000 anymore. And as a result, this couple had rediscovered each other and reconciled. That's a good example how financial spring cleaning and organizing one's finances and being on the same page with your partner can lead to a happy ending. I would like to share the second story, how the financial issues were not the financial issues on the surface, but were really psychological issues. A walking client comes to my office asking me to start preparing financial disclosure because they're heading to marriage breakdown. And as I dig deeper and I uncover that they have a house and they have a pension, I find that no way the husband wants to share his pension. He didn't want to listen to any reasoning, to any tax analysis, any charts and graphs I prepared. He simply said, no way I'm sharing my pension. And reversely, the wife did not want to share the house. She was almost married to this house. I have to be really delicate in these situations. I can't tell my client, hey, you have to see a psychotherapist, okay? I position it a little bit like, how about looking differently and maybe speak to a life coach or maybe discuss your life plans? And I position the referral to a therapist eventually who is also acting as a life coach to check how they think. And apparently what I learned later that for the husband, his pension was his identity. He spent 25 years in the same company. All the promotions, all the ups and downs, all resonated in his mind with this big pension plan. And likewise, the house was wife's identity because she picked the curtains, she ordered the chairs, she furnished everything. And for her, it was like selling her baby. And after that psychological work was done with the both and they could detach their lives from assets, they were able to move on with a good, solid financial plan I prepared for them. So fellow Toastmasters, what comes first, psychology or money, is for you to decide. And I think the convergence of the two is what is important. Recognizing that what you feel, what you aspire, and how much money in the bank you have all in one, that's what made a successful relationship and ultimately successful.